lack of audio with something.
Okay.
Yeah, we've got half an hour of dead air that Red's going to fill with something.
Yep. Yeah.
And then we'll upload it.
Half an hour? Oh, that's even more than I thought. It was 50 minutes.
I'm not looking forward to this. Because he's going to give me Nav's accent.
Oh no, trust me, I have an idea of how I'm going to start. I'm not planning anything else. I'll wing it from there.
Right. So, last episode, after the silent movie version of the finale to the first Westlake saga, which was not quite as impressive as I thought it was going to be. It seemed to be missing a final act. But you've taken on a new job. You were hired to move some unspecified cargo.
It was specified. They were just lying about it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That cargo turned out to be a serial killer called M'Hard. Kirk M'Hard.
What are you gonna do?
I just realized the pun in that name. Holy shit.
Yeah. They're pretty bad with the names. They sneak up on you.
Oh, yeah.
And, yeah, so you successfully snuck him out of the sheriff's office and to the Daedalus. Turns out he's a bit of a loony. He was ranting things about Reavers and needing to save the whole planet by killing everybody. And he also mentioned the Westlake at one point. Red.
Well, that makes him totally crazy.
Yeah. Red should have an asset complication still. That's disappeared.
Oh, weird.
You had a complication that he knew your deepest, darkest fears.
Yep.
That's going to stick around, I'm afraid. That one doesn't go away just yet.
Oh, I don't want it to go away yet.
It was
fun.
Also more than a D6, wasn't it?
It was a D8.
It's a D8.
Yeah.
Before you could take off, though, your ship was surrounded by the angry mob, and their leader, one Albert Rainey, insisted on being led on board to make sure that you actually took M'Hard to the prison.
Yes, which was all very reasonable. So, being the reasonable man that Saps is, he just was like, "Okay, come on board. We'll accommodate you in however you want." Okay, we're about an hour away. Good. Please get out. Buzz off.
So you now
don't let the door hit you on the way out.
Because you got rid of a plot critical NPC.
Not for the first time.
Nope.
Not this time he's
this one.
This time
not
he's alive. This time he's alive. I didn't kill him.
No, he's fine.
He's just got about a day's walk back to town through the desert.
No, an hour.
No, an hour. It wasn't that bad.
I specifically chose an hour because I didn't want to inconvenience him, give it any chance that he'd die. And then they'll get blamed on us.
And so with M'Hard knocked out in the cargo hold, you were starting to break atmo.
Mm-hmm.
When the other ship that was docked at the planet when you arrived, the McKnight, appeared behind you with its turret pointed at you, and that's where we left it.
Yes. Right.
Laura has props now.
More toys. Good.
This one's actually a real airsoft gun.
Nice.
So what are we doing?
The
only thing I can manage is this.
Nice.
That's cheating. I'll find my gun.
I have a piece of wood, so ha.
Wood?
Can't do anything against that, Keep.
Eliza, code G.
Okay.
We do that.
We do the thing.
We do the thing.
We do the thing. Captain,
what's our best approach here? Do we want to try to out firepower them, or should we try to be tactical?
One sec. Beep. Hello, McKnight. I see that you've got your guns pointed right at us. What the frell?
That's not the word we use here.
I don't care.
We speak Chinese instead.
Also hump.
Struggle! Woman's voice
comes over the intercom.
Hump or Goram.
Goram.
What's your ship called this week?
Oh, it's a good question. Did we decide on what it's called this week?
McNegative Wisdom?
No.
Yes.
It was the Nugget of Wisdom.
Nugget of Wisdom. I won't allow that.
Nugget of Wisdom. Come on. McKnight, McNugget. Come on.
Yeah. The rest of us was all, it was the McNugget, but Rhett was, the Nugget of Wisdom.
I thought we agreed that Wu had actually painted the Mook on our...
Yeah.
Wu had. At the MC. So I'll say the Nugget of Wisdom.
Okay.
Unless they're looking at the...
So this is a different lady from the one that you met that was cleaning the landing gear before. And she says, we're really sorry, McNugget. We were just heading out to Atma ourselves. There appears to be a small problem with our targeting computer. We'll get that sorted right away.
Okay. Can we both just move in opposite directions to solve that problem, then?
Absolutely, McNugget. They drift off to one side, and the...
Okay, I drift off to the other side.
To normal.
Okay. Well, there we go, then. All a big misunderstanding. Nothing to worry about.
Yep. Really? Okay.
Let's make a note of it for now.
Okay. So you've broken Atmo. It's a couple of days out to Constance, where you're going. At the moment, Emhard is knocked out because Isaac punched him out.
Yep.
Okay, I want a guard on him at all times. Eliza, Isaac, Nia, you three can rotate. If you need to go to the toilet, ask somebody else, including me or, God damn it.
Woo.
So, woo! What we did last episode was we strapped him down in Eliza's medical bay.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
So, he's in there. How are we going to feed him?
Intravenously sounds good.
Mm. Wow. Not a bad idea, actually. I like that.
Should have the tools right here.
Intravenous flu. Yes, that's a good plan. So we'll clamp him down, and then we'll have a rotating guard shift. 4-hour slots should do it. I'll take the first watch.
Can it be 8-hour slots instead?
You want to sit in the room for 8 hours, do you?
I'd rather sit in a room 8 hours than have to get up twice in a night.
Eliza can take night
shift. I want proper
then.
Sleep.
Yeah, you get to sleep 8 hours, remember?
Yeah, it's 4 hours on for you, 4 hours on someone else, back to you.
Yeah, you're going to go stir crazy after 4-hour shifts. That's how Desert Buzz 1 happened.
Why do you want 8 hours then? 4 hours is...
8 hours means you have 16 hours off. That's 8 hours of leisure, 8 hours of sleep.
Yeah, in that case, you get 8 hours of sleep between one of your shifts and 8 hours of leisure between another of your shifts. That's how it works if you do 4-hour shifts.
Either way, 4 hours is the optimal period for staying alert.
Yeah.
And we need to be alert.
I'm going
to
be 8 hours alive. With Isaac on that.
Also, I should probably... I'll do the...
At this point, Nova pipes up. She's got some limited medical training and would like to know if she could assist.
Sure.
Yeah,
we can get her to help. I mean, if she's all right being around a psychotic killer.
She's a little nervous, but she's a companion. She's just seen her fair share of weirdos.
Just don't
she's
touch
hanging
him.
Out with us.
Yeah, that's her.
How well, bad can it
just
be?
Just don't go near him, because I don't know what
you're doing. What was Nutcase's name again?
Emhard.
It
was Emhard. Kirk Lee Emhard. Confirmed serial killer.
Okay.
For the terrible crime surname.
Got it. Oh, no. Smaller.
I like that.
Good job.
I didn't know how to spell Emhard. Oh, there is Emhard. Okay, I'll use it.
No, just leave it like that. That's great.
Okay. So are you just going to keep him strapped down, or are you going
to
keep...
Something's onto us.
No, just strapped down. Sedated seems a bit dangerous, actually.
Okay.
Like, keeping some of these sedated for several days, that's probably not safe.
So we can't keep him under, but we can keep him tied up.
Yeah. He can pee through a tube.
I could probably give him some strong, like, hallucinogenic drugs.
So the tube will be fine.
So that he wouldn't know where he is.
Oh yeah,
just give him the worst trip of the trip of his lifetime.
Yeah, no.
Let's make the crazy guy crazier. That can't hurt anyone.
Yeah, precisely.
I mean, technically, he's already crazy, and I would like to study the effects of hallucinogenic drugs on super crazy people.
Then you can watch him 24/7.
I slap Eliza on the back of the head. No.
Eliza, is your middle name Varlan?
Yeah.
No. It's not Varlan.
Would you like to experiment on some aliens?
If we have some, of course I would. That would be interesting.
I think Wu might qualify, but I don't think she's up for experimentation.
Not that kind.
Okay, so who is taking first shift?
Me.
Okay.
Dips on middle.
I was going to relieve him. Fine.
Dips on middle.
Fine, I will take third shift then.
So, actually, one rule. There are no weapons taken into the room or sharp objects of any kind.
No, weapons don't need to be sharp. That's fine.
No,
so glad you just said that.
I'll go remove all the sharp weapons then from my operating room.
Yes, you will.
Idiot.
What I love is that he now just... Eliza just opens a cupboard and just rifle after rifle she starts moving out of the med bay.
Yeah. No, there's no scalpels or anything
in
there.
That's the drawers underneath the sink. From the cupboard, it's all the knives and sauce and other stuff like that.
Oh, right.
Needles. Don't forget the needles.
Always the needles.
So we take those out of the room, and then Isaac, everyone checks their weapons outside the room, and let's have the relieving person unlock the door as well.
Mm-hmm.
Man, I let him in there and get that guy.
Okay. So for your first shift, Nav.
Yeah.
I would like you to roll mental and focus against...
Oh. Oh, good. Oh, this can't end bad. This can't end badly at all.
It's a 14.
It's a 14.
Sorry.
It's only a 14.
Oh, goody.
Anyone can do anything with that.
Mental and focus. Do I get to know what I'm mental and focusing against?
Yeah, being rattled by Emhart talking to
okay.
you.
Oh, right. Oh, he's a nut job. So, in that case, I will use my mental of D8 plus my D4. Wait, is that D4 in focus? Yes, it is.
Probably. It's the same for me.
I'm going to take my D8 strong silent type. Do. I can't think of anything else that I need to roll.
Oh, off by one.
Oh.
But you do have a plot point.
I do have a plot point.
On the other hand, it would be interesting, Phil.
No, don't worry about it. Eliza's gonna go stark crazy. She is not built to handle that insanity.
Yeah, I will spend a plot point.
You have plenty.
Yeah. And keep the 2 to put it to a 15.
What was it? The nugget of
wisdom. The McNugget of wisdom.
Nugget of wisdom.
Mick, nugget of wisdom.
The nugget of wisdom. Got it.
So yeah, Isaac, as your shift passes, Emhard tries various tactics between ranting and raving. You get the sense that despite his outward appearance of being a psychopath and whatever, that actually all along he's been trying to question you, figure out how you would react.
Ah.
Sort of getting a deep sense of you.
React to what?
He's Black Widowing me.
Yeah.
Okay. you said he mentioned the Westlake, did you?
Yeah, he talks about every now and then. He just drops a little cryptic reference to the Westlake.
I'm actually going to ask him. Where do you know? What does that name mean to you?
And he replies, "I'm Kirkley Emhard, formerly of the good ship Westlake, and now the savior of Mogarutu."
Okay. See, that's interesting. Okay, well, thank you for your opinions.
Insight.
Guys, he's crazy. Oh shit.
But yeah, all through though, he talks about needing to save Mogarutu to save them from what's coming, from a face worse than death.
So to save them from a face worse than death, he kills them.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because that's not as bad.
That's just death.
Yes.
I mean that's interesting. I don't have a lot else to ask him, but I don't think a crazy man ranting and raving about non-existent things are going to be too important. So Isaac spends most of the thing just sort of staring at him and occasionally replying.
Yeah, and so your shift passes uneventfully. You figured out Emhard's game, and yeah, he doesn't really get to you. And so now it's time for second shift.
Yes.
I'm going to warn Eliza about that.
It's not going to help.
Like, you know, be careful. He is trying to get to people, and he's trying to figure us out, and he's trying to get a read on us, and he's basically trying to gather intel. My advice is just not talk to him.
I don't have to talk, I just have to listen to go crazy. But yes.
We're not going to make it to third shift, are we?
Probably.
Possibly. It might happen if we're lucky.
Because I've got a really great roll against this, and I can probably even have enough to, you know, possibly interrogate him and or turn him, but yeah.
I'm going to go crazy, and I guarantee it, because...
Well, he's going to start talking about Reavers to you.
Yeah, that's the thing, right? Because he's going to start talking, and I'm rolling my ship's doctor as a D4, because I'm curious to look at him to understand his psychosis. I'm also rolling my Veteran of the Unification War as a D4, because I've seen some shit.
Wait, you can't roll two distinctions, right? You can only choose one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Only one?
Yeah. Sadly, only one.
I'm still going to roll 2d4, so...
That's fair.
So, yeah. So you get in and settle down for your shift, and he starts off with his usual pattern of random nonsense. But then he gets on to the topic of... we're never actually saying the name Reavers, but start saying, "You don't know what's coming. I've got to save Mogarutu. Save them from a fate worse than death. The things that are coming, what they will do to them. I've got to save them."
Okay, and you have to set the stakes, right?
Yes. I was just wondering if you wanted to respond to that first.
No, because Eliza's just observing him.
Okay. Wait, shouldn't
for now.
Shouldn't Eliza set the stakes? Because she's defending against his rants?
The way it's set up is... I set the stakes, and then you succeed or fail against him.
It's probably not going to matter whether I roll first or not.
13.
No, probably not.
I can't beat that. Unless I use a plot point.
Roll anyway.
Oh yeah.
You can't even beat that with a plot point.
No, not when I roll a one, but like I said, crazy. But I get a plot point because I'm curious.
I'm going to use that jinx, and you can have a D8. M Hart knows my fears as well.
D8?
Yeah. Because then I get a plot point as well.
You failed to raise a stick, so that's a D6, and I'm going to use the plot point to step it up one.
So I get 2 plot points, Keeb.
Yes.
Because I was curious to know of his insanity, and now I know.
Yeah.
Yeah, you get.
Won't
you
join me, Saps? Saps, join me in the operating room.
Emhart really prays. He's narrowed in the way he reacted when he started talking about Reavers.
Yes.
And he starts questioning you. He says he can see something in your eyes that you know what he's talking about.
My only response is that I've seen them before, and then total silence, and she just shuts down completely. She just sits there and can see nothing. You know that million-yard stare?
Mm-hmm.
It's just, she's not even there mentally anymore.
Yep. Okay. While Eliza's doing that, let me get to the right bit of page. There we go. Zaps, I presume you're up in the cockpit?
No, I'm sleeping.
Okay. is anybody monitoring the cockpit?
At some point I had to sleep, so I figured Zaps would do that, and I'd maybe pop by in the last
probably
shift.
That's probably what I'm doing, since I'm going to be on my next shift anyway, so I'm probably up in the cockpit reading and or just monitoring things. Listening on the comm, because hey, somebody has to be up there.
Yep.
Not always, but it helps.
When transporting a dangerous fugitive, one is always manning cockpit.
Yes.
I guess that's fair.
You may have a choice of mental and notice or mental and operate.
Oh, me?
Yep.
Alright, let me check what I want to roll on that then. Mental and notice or mental and operate? We're going to go with notice.
Yep.
I'm going to roll mental and notice, and does that get anything else?
Your expertise for flying is with small ships, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, so that doesn't come in here.
Okay, so we're getting mental and notice.
Maybe a distinction?
I don't know. What distinction am I going to apply? What are we talking about?
What distinction do you have?
Well, we have first mate for hire. We have Wudang style, which is unarmed fighting and Zen. And then we also have deadly aim.
I'd expect first mate for hire.
I would give an extra D6 for being on high alert.
Okay.
Wouldn't also first mate for hire help, because it specifically references ships? So she's used to doing stuff like this?
Mm. I can roll it as a D4 just because I'm for hire.
Yeah.
I like that. Yeah, I'm watching, but I'm really?
Well, it's like, I'm first mate for hire. It's like, I'm not intimately familiar with this ship, not yet. And it's, you know, this is for hire work. I mean, yeah, I'm on your side, but I'm not
Zaps has done a lot of custom routing of stuff to fix.
Yeah, that sounds like Zaps.
Yeah, so I'm like, that's the bad button. Okay, we're good. All right, so we're going to roll that. What is the command again? Is it slash roll or
slash R?
We're just going to do that, because I can't seem to get anything else right. Oh, for the love of... There we go.
Hey.
Yeah. That is... Yep, 15.
So that's success.
Ooh, and plot point!
Yep.
And a big damn hero dice.
Indeed. That's what it. That's what I tried to say, if I could remember the name of it. It's a success.
D8. Big damn hero dice.
Thank you.
An excessive success.
Extraordinary.
Ah, yep.
That's right. The word.
Yeah, my my mental focus roll wasn't going to be much different.
You realize you're being followed.
Ah, joy! Who is it?
Why,
it's the McKnight.
Knight. Called yep. it!
Yeah. They look like they're on an intercept course. They are gaining on you. You've got maybe about 20 minutes before they get to your position.
Hey, Captain! I think you need to wake up. We got company.
I had the most wonderful dream.
I told you not to drink that much before going to bed. Now get your ass up here. We got company. They're on an intercept course and gaining. We have 20 minutes.
You see Zaps coming. Anybody who might be looking in the corridor, you see Zaps coming through the corridor in his... what do you call that? That robe that Undy? Looks... That's you know, that robe that's made of the same stuff towels are made of.
Yeah.
Terracloth robe?
Terracloth robe.
Turkish robe, yes.
Yeah, and while he's walking through the hallways with that, with his hat on. His pajamas.
I was expecting like a little turtle onesie or something. Okay, so, yeah.
I actually like so's better. Like, he has that underneath just his underwear, tiny whities.
Yeah.
And a top hat.
And I could see him wearing one of the white string vests as well.
Yeah, probably. He just walks into the cockpit. What's happening?
So McKnight's following us. They are gaining. We need to either evade them, get away, or somehow convince them to go away.
Zap seems to relax a little bit. Walks over to the pilot seat. Sits down. Takes over control. Goes looking for the stealth system. It's like, okay, let's see if we can shake them.
Okay. That will be mental and fly.
Ooh, I'll take it.
And also your relevant ship stat for the stealth system.
Yes, so that's the D8. I think it's the D8 build for stealth. So, yeah.
Oh, you also get a D6 because you noticed the McKnight early.
Okay. D6 plus the 1d8 or
I think I'm asleep right now.
Ship. Yeah.
You probably There's are, yes.
1d8 for the mental. 10 plus d6.
And it'll be a 14 to beat.
Ooh, impressive.
And no jinxes.
You're enjoying the 14s tonight.
Doing quite well tonight, for change.
Dang it, that makes it harder for us.
Traitor of both sides, or shady business. I'm trying to see if there's any way I can get a plot point, because I think I have this in the bag anyway, but there's probably none of my distinctions that work here anyway.
I mean, they're trying to aim their laser turret at you again.
There we go.
Nervous around
technically,
guns.
That's a gun.
A turret is a sort of gun.
Is a type of gun. Keep highest 2. There we go.
Oh.
Good job!
Nice.
And I get a plot point because I used.
Yep.
The nerves aren't guns. There we go. Do you want to use that jinx?
Nope.
Okay. That should be enough to shake them, I hope.
Yeah, you almost succeed in shaking them. You need an extraordinary success here to completely shake them. As you're sort of trying to evade them, you realize that they probably weren't kidding earlier about having problems with their targeting computers. The laser turret was really having difficulty locking onto you. I mean, the stealth system's probably helping that. But just as you're about to evade them, Oh, ghost nav again. They get off a lucky shot, and your engines are temporarily disabled. The whole ship is.
That's my impression of Zaps.
Brilliant.
Hold on, I can't.
Oh, there we go. Yeah, that seems about right. That does seem about right. Yep. Nice.
And so, with your engine slightly damaged, she's able to pull alongside and dock.
Wow.
The pirate.
That's what you get for a success.
Yeah.
Imagine what would happen if you had failed.
Oh yeah.
And I don't have enough fix to work on the engines.
That's fine. I can repair if push comes to shove.
Am I back?
Yes, you're back.
Cool. So yeah, the Daedalus has just been temporarily disabled by a lucky shot from the laser cannon. The McKnight is pulling along side and preparing to board. You do have enough notice that you'll be able to set up an attack in the
air. I think we need to
We
need to have a welcome party.
They're coming aside, right?
Yeah.
What? Huh?
Isaac, welcome party. Get back here.
Oh, okay, Isaac's like, 30 to 40 seconds later, you see Isaac running out of the room, like, pulling his tie up, being like, oh,
he's just got the tie. He's not managed to get the shirt on. So he's there in just the tie and his love heart boxer shorts.
He's got the shirt, he's got the boxer shorts, he's got the jacket and the tie, but no trousers.
Pants!
Oh, yeah, okay, hang on. You're right, thanks, Nia. The boxers, like, disappeared back down the corridor. And
Nia, like, turns to the camera and goes, how did they survive before I got here?
Cute audience laughter.
Ha 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 ha. Ain't we
a That's you, Sosa. You need to laugh.
Yeah, pretty much it's Sosa today.
Yeah, that works. That works, Fred, when you shout at the audience, laugh!
What else are we?
We should never play this game drunk.
Well, I'm starting.
I'm not even drunk.
I'm not drunk either. Okay, one beer's not going to do it, but really.
I've had half a beer. I'm not nowhere close.
I have like two
sips of that thing.
So they're
pulling alongside to dock, right?
Yeah, so about that. Where are our turrets exactly on the ship?
I assumed you had one top, one bottom.
Oh, okay. I thought they were the sides. No, that works. Works even better.
Yeah. Point of note. So, obviously, the ship being shot woke Isaac up. What about Wu?
Wu's in the bar. So
we
he's
have
really
a bar?
We have Wu.
It's in the lounge.
Yeah, I'm gonna assume...
She means her bunk, probably.
I'm gonna assume...
They're basically the same thing.
Actually gonna assume that when Wu came aboard, there wasn't a bar, but Wu has used some of her savings in the last couple of episodes to build a bar inside the ship.
I imagine it started out like you had like a little breakfast bar thing, and Wu's kind of remodeled it, and you've got a couple of...
We used to have a reading room right next to Wu's bunk, and it's kind of been taken over, and now there's, like, it's Wu's bunk that goes right into the bar.
Yeah. I mean, it has upped the value of the ship, so I put up with it.
Nova was also immediately woken up. She's grabbed a pistol and a knife and is joining you guys.
Okay.
Eliza... Do you get shaken out of your reverie by this?
Mm-hmm.
Because you hear us thundering down the hall.
Yep. I gag the idiot, and I that's not Wu. I gag the idiot on my operating table, and then I walk out.
Ah. You see, there's a problem.
Yeah, I was going to say, there is a problem.
You go to look at the idiot on the operating table. He's not there.
You lost
again.
I lost the criminal complication there.
As you look at the bed sort of stare.
Look up and just...
You feel a scalpel near your throat.
Oh, no.
Oh.
We're about to lose a crew member, aren't we?
Oh, no.
Not yet.
Oh, no.
What happened?
I'm being held at knife point.
Oh. Yep.
Seems you missed one scalpel somewhere, and he's been able to get...
Top right drawer. Top right hole. Right
minor detail. Something that we talked about that actually would have prevented from Eliza going out of the room anyway. Didn't we lock the door from the outside?
Yes,
we did, and I have not come on shift because I've been sitting in the cockpit waiting till 2 a.m. or whenever I take over.
Oh yeah, so we can't get out, so I'm locked inside the room with the crazy guy.
Yes, and obviously Isaac and Nia are unaware because we're running...
Who has a scalpel. And of course I didn't bring my earpiece in because...
Yep, and you haven't got any weapons with you.
Well,
oh boy.
Time to try and knock him the fuck out.
Weapons don't have to be sharp.
Yep. Well, we'll come back to you. You're, Zaps, you were about to try and deal with your boarders.
Okay. Do they just storm in, or do I get a chance to talk?
Well, they at the moment they're coming alongside to dock. They aren't responding to any hails.
So they're not responding.
Your turrets are operational. Your engines will be back online in a couple of minutes.
How's that laser cannon doing?
Struggling. It kind of seems to be locked in one position at the moment. It's not tracking you at all. It's kind of pointing in the opposite direction.
Okay. So they're coming alongside me. My engines are dead, right?
You've got partial power, but you can't outmaneuver them at the moment.
Okay, I'm assuming I don't have main engines. Do I have maneuvering thrusters?
Yes, you do.
And I spin the ship.
Yep.
Let's not be too hasty, guys. You know what? You call them and ask. Seriously, call them. I'm busy with something else.
I mean, I'm not saying don't try and give them alcohol, but I'm saying set fire to it first.
In a bottle. Yeah. With a little rag sticking out the top.
I'd like to...
They're just doing the responsible thing and swapping insurance details.
I'm actually gonna... I want to spin the ship so that the turrets are pointed at them. At basically the spot that they're trying to dock us with.
Yep.
Okay.
Do I need to make a roll for that?
They see the turrets, but... They try and adjust their course to match your spin, and the turret starts jerking round as they're trying to get it back into position again.
So they keep doing that?
Yep.
Do our turrets have any automated targeting systems or something? Can I use them from here? Or do they have to be manned?
You need somebody to man them.
Yeah, I was ready to...
Well, we got two people who can go.
Can somebody get on the bottom gun and shoot these assholes?
Eliza. Eliza.
Who's going? I'm going. I'm running towards. I take off
to
medical bay. Medical bay, and I'm not carrying my pointy things. I'm carrying the rest of my arsenal, which is not pointy.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter if
you've got like things with strings and rocks.
You can take whatever you want, there's a problem.
Okay, fine, we're taking this, let's go.
Zaps, Woo, I'm gonna need backup down here. I can't take these guys by myself.
I'm the best thing I can do to keep them off us. Do you want me down there?
Or do you want me preventing
them from keep. Can I outmaneuver them long enough to
with
get
no
the engines back online? That way I got maneuvering thrusters.
At the current, they will likely force dock before your engines come back.
Stop listing lazily to the left.
From the way that they're maneuvering, they don't look especially skilled pilots, so it looks like at some point they may just give up trying to match your rotation and just force dock and ram you.
So we need to decide if we want to fight them off as boarders or want to shoot them.
Shoot them.
The guns.
As you can hear them, shoot them! And keeps running.
Yeah.
Okay.
Nova Isaac, asks if she can help. She says she might be able to shoot a turret.
Oh, actually, Nova, you do that. Shoot the turret. Woo, get on the other one.
Wu lazily just walks towards the next gun with a bottle in hand.
Now I am scared.
Like rage. These things
now I'm scared. Now I'm scared. I'm in the hands of a crazy person, and I'm scared when I hear Wu get on the gun.
Look, it's empty space. The only thing she can hit is the other ship.
Or us.
About that.
No.
It's Wu. She can hit us.
Okay.
I'm assuming that's impossible.
Wu is a magical girl. She can hit us.
That is true.
Wu, you will be rolling your mental, your operate.
Oh, God.
The ship's systems, which I believe is a D8, mm-hmm. and whatever the dice is for the cannon, the turrets. And this will count for
you. I'm actually going to look that up because I don't know what.
So it's a mental plus operate.
Give me a sec. I'll give you a moment. Tabletop RPGs, Firefly.
Mental operate, a D8 for the ship. I think it's a D8 for the cannons as well.
Yeah, I think that's a D8.
Yeah, probably. Signature assets, probably D8. I'll go track it down in the rule book, but assume it's a D8.
Says mental operate and 2 D8s.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh.
Yeah. It's hidden weapons is a D8.
Yeah. You've only got to beat a 5.
Okay. Have you done it right?
Yay!
Yeah.
That's an extraordinary success.
You get a D8. God, Wu!
What the hell?
I told you, Wu is a magical girl.
And you all doubt
me. Wu has this magical transformation. That's not the correct one. There we go.
And Nav was so surprised he ghosted.
Wu!
Wu's doing pretty well on the big damn hero dice this adventure.
She'll save every one of us.
Yeah, don't worry, I'll just tally this to the end of the adventures, and I'll backdate you.
So yeah, you and Nova successfully man the turrets. You start sort of shooting. It's mostly sort of covering fire. It's a little tricky to hit the McKnight because of how Zaps has been maneuvering. But they start taking evasive maneuvers. It messes up their docking approach. You're able to get your engines back online and get away from them.
Yeah, I'm probably not going to tangle with that cannon. Consider disabling their ship, but no, let's not do that.
Yep, so you're just going to hard burn away.
Yeah. I was like, bye! Okay, half a crisis solved.
Yeah. I'm getting ready to roll. What you want, Keith?
Hey, I get first crack at the psycho.
You have a scalpel to your neck, dear.
Do you even know how to fight? It's not that difficult.
I love that everybody just looked.
Eliza knows. That's fine. It'll be fine, I'm sure.
I'd rather have the cool-looking shit than the other things.
There's plenty of ways you can deal with someone trying to stab you.
It'll be fine. Yes.
Roll all ones.
No, because if I do that, I'm dead.
So you also have a D10 no sudden moves complication.
Yeah.
Oh, Eliza does.
Yeah, of course I do.
Any rolls you make here will be high stakes and will result, if you fail, in Eliza being taken out. She's not dead, but she will require medical attention to get back in. She
luckily,
can't
we have
a plot point to remain in the scene.
Luckily, we have a very good doctor on the ship.
Yeah, indeed. that's a good point.
The best of doctors, yes. In fact.
Also, yeah, but
can you self treat yourself?
Of course I can.
No, when you're knocked out.
Right.
It's not a problem.
One of us will be reviving.
I just stay awake.
Sheer force of will.
Yes.
Taking out means one of us will be reviving you.
Yeah, we'll be fine. Yeah. It'll be fine. Everything is.
All right.
God, I'm dead. So
what are
dead.
We rolling?
And
do
who's
I have
rolling?
To save our ass at this point?
Right. Sorry, I'm just checking exactly how I want to run this. Because there was a couple of scenarios that could have resulted in Ahmad getting free, but fortunately Eliza played straight into the one I was looking for.
Oh, good.
I'm good at that. I'm Keeb's enabler on this team, just FYI.
Yeah, so Emhard, you arrive down at the med bay. You can see through the door. It's still locked. Emhard has a scalpel to Eliza's throat, and he appears to be gesturing her to unlock the door from the inside.
Okay. I'm actually going to encourage her to open the door, and I step back from the door to have a little better chance in that brief window when she's opening it to get at him before he's obviously going to slit her throat as soon as she opens the door.
Yep.
Do you want me to take the other approach?
I'm assuming Nia knows that Eliza can't open the door from the inside.
Oh, I forgot, yeah. Actually, yes, then I want her to still come closer to the door. The closer they are to the door, the better of a chance I have.
Got it.
Okay. Does the door open in or out?
It just slides open.
Slides. Okay, good. Alright, that's actually even better. Great. Yes, I'm going to motion her to come closer to the door. And
there's an intercom beside the door so you can speak into the room if you want to.
Well, all I'm going to say is, like, Eliza, don't worry, I'm coming. And then in hands, you can see just my fingers at the bottom of the window saying, come here. Come closer. Eliza, don't worry, I'm out here. Do whatever he wants.
Okay. So, are you going to follow through with that, Eliza?
I'm not sure. I really want to punch him. I really want to make this fight.
You'll get a chance to fight him. Let's do it when there's a scalpel away from your throat.
I mean,
here's the thing.
And fight, and he will be rolling that D10 against you.
Yeah,
and that D8.
If you take yourself out, I am not. If you take yourself out, I am not reviving you.
Then you have a death on your hands, and can Nia live with that?
What do you think?
Yeah. What do you think? Nia's not afraid of Niska, so, you know, she's fine
True.
With that.
True.
I mean,
fine, I'll just go closer to the door. I'll do the smart thing.
Remember, you've been 10,000 yard stare for quite some time. Are you going to be in any condition to fight back?
There's a lot of rage coming from that place.
Okay, just get close enough to the door and we can deal with that. Alright.
I'll just move closer to the door and try to make sure that he doesn't know what we're up to.
Yes. You move close enough to... When they are close enough to the door, I'm going to throw it open as fast as I can from the outside and try to knock Eliza away from the scalpel as fast as I can. I don't know how tightly he's holding her. And if
can't I
can't get...
just drop when you open the door?
If you can. If his arm is loose enough that you can get through, yes. Otherwise, I've got to go straight for the scalpel and try to disarm him.
So how is she holding... so I presume
I'm assuming
like...
I'm
yeah.
standard. So I'm assuming yeah. standard hold, which is around the neck.
So
no. I'm guessing more like Nav has it, where it's the scalpel to the neck from the almost arm's reach.
Stupid hold. Good. Yeah. I can work with stupid hold.
I'm depending. Like, is she behind or in front?
He's behind.
He's using Eliza as a shield.
He's behind.
He's bigger than Eliza.
So he's got this going on.
Mm-hmm.
Probably more the sensible serial killer hold. He's an idiot, this guy.
So I'm going to have to...
He's got standard one for there that is,
if he tries anything, he will probably...
Yeah, okay.
So when Mia opens the door, I will have to try and move his hand out of the way.
As long as you can put some resistance on, we're good.
Hip twist and shoulders up. So, hip, and then you're gonna
take a slice to the neck, but it won't be that deep. So we can push that.
Maybe we'll see.
Yeah.
So who's gonna move first? Will it be Eliza? Because you don't have to roll to open the door.
It's technically my move first because I'm going to open the door and then Eliza can react and.
Yeah, but the opening of the door, Keep just said we don't have to roll, so it's probably my roll first.
Yeah.
Okay.
Whether you wanted to open the door and barrel in as the first action or let Eliza move before you barrel
in. Actually, I want to barrel in as the first action because that throws him off guard, hopefully.
Actually, okay. Tackle me.
Yeah, just something like that.
Me instead.
We can try. Whatever gets through.
I'm guessing Nia knows a bit about combat. Nia knows a lot about combat, right? So Nia would know that the best way to make sure that I won't get hurt is basically to make us both fall backwards.
I just don't want that scalpel because it's a small sharp blade piercing into you in the wrong location when you go down.
Yeah. That's the hard part. I'll still have 25 to 40 seconds if I get pierced, so...
Okay.
I'm not a medic.
Nia,
I am, and I know.
You will be rolling physical and move, and any of your appropriate skills.
Physical plus, and I'm going to roll my dexterity with my move, as I think this is going to require dexterity. Definitely rolling my Wudang style. I don't know if I can include my arsenal in this or not.
No.
Okay.
Thirteen with three jinxes to beat.
Okay.
I'm spending a plot point.
Okay.
Good choice.
What are you going to do?
Well, you can reduce one plot point. You can remove the no sudden moves, actually. Mm-hmm. On the other hand, it doesn't really matter anymore because he's already rolled it.
Yeah.
Yeah, but he keeps rolled this, which means that I can remove the complication from me, the no sudden moves, which means what basically happens is as soon as Nia opens the door, I knock the scalpel out of the way.
Well, that complication won't apply for any future actions.
Yeah, but it still applies for this one.
It still applies for this role.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it doesn't matter. But I could give him a complication.
You could give him a complication.
Ooh. You can roll that in your roll in a moment. So.
Yeah, but I'm just thinking what complication would make sense.
Do you want to let Nia roll first? You can still choose to spend the plot point after that.
Yeah. Okay. Nia can roll first, but I'm considering rolling a plot point, but I just need a good thing for the complication. Basically.
Eliza, consider this. Instead of rolling Wudang, which I cannot use any triggers on, I can also roll first mate for hire, also as a positive here, because I have a trigger active that lets me re-roll any dice that comes up at ones when I'm helping a crew member out.
But I don't roll ones. I'm the one that's proven not to roll ones at all.
Okay, then I'll roll Wudang, but I don't have a trigger I can use with it.
I love how the rest of the crew is actually silent on that.
They all don't agree with it.
Or they're so stunned that they can't act.
It's the latter. I'll be honest, it's the latter.
Even I wouldn't try to pull so blatant
a lot. I just
want to
see what happens.
Okay. Here's rolling. Oh! I may need to spend a plot point.
So close.
Yeah. I'm going to spend a plot point and keep one of the fours.
Yep.
Okay, so that takes me up to 15.
Yep. So you slam the door control. The door opens. Do you want to describe what happens next?
Yeah. The door opens, and I'm almost... It's kind of unlocked, and I'm almost pushing it out of the way as I barrel in, and I'm trying to grab his hand and twist it a bit away from Eliza, and then I use my body to slam them both to the floor. Hopefully Eliza has enough sense to roll out as soon as I give her an opening.
Yep.
So it's basically get down Mr. President, but she's also pulling away the knife.
Yes.
Yep. Slash scalpel.
And hopefully this is where you think enough to push it away, helping the action, and then can roll out is the option.
Ooh, I have a good idea for a complication for him. As we land, Nia knees him in the groin.
That would be a very big possibility.
Yeah, because the way it looks, right? You get in there, we fall over, and Nia's like there, and boom, knee to the groin, and as the men can attest on this panel, that hurts.
Oh yeah, it does. A lot.
Yeah, and spending that's D6, D8, D10.
Yes.
So, D10. There goes that plot point.
D10 crack nuts. Complication.
I was just going to say cracker. Massive pain.
Yep. I prefer crack nuts, but it's not mine. So. give it the name, whatever you want.
D10 of should have seen that coming.
I like So-So's one. Bruised fruits.
Ooh, that is good.
Ah, my chat has died. Crap.
Bruised okay. Fruits. I actually remember. I forgot to override. Oh no, I did. Did do that. It's like, did I actually put this on Firefly mode? Because I'm going to give that a groan.
Which one?
So-so's suggestion of bruised fruits.
Still very good.
So, what it says here, if you raise the stakes, M. Hard is taken out. If possible, he will spend a plot point to take a complication and leave the fight. Unfortunately, here...
We don't get paid if he gets taken out.
Well, taken out is not
Oh, true, yeah. Right.
Taken out is not there.
Which means you'll basically be able to put him back in captivity. I'm just trying to figure out if there is a way for him to actually leave this fight. Like,
I don't
maybe
think so.
He was in the middle of unscrewing some air ducts or something.
He'd have to go out through the door, most likely, because the door's now open.
Door's now open, but you're kind of partially in the way.
I mean, I could see
Eliza,
that.
I presume.
I could actually see it. Oh, go ahead.
I'm not going to check Eliza. The first thing I'm going to do is resecure him, and Eliza will get you in 10 seconds.
So that's the thing. Like, is Eliza, does Nia know if Eliza is wounded?
I'm still securing the dude first.
Right. Yeah. So, what state? What is it? What state is Emhart in?
He's groggy, but no more than that.
He's a little bit groggy, but not too bad. I mean, he's just.
So the thing that if I was Emhart, I would throw Eliza at Nia. Press the scalpel into her hand and throw her at Nia and see what happened, and then run based on that.
But we're on a pile on the ground.
Okay, but let's take a different approach. So you charge, the knife doesn't get in anybody's neck. There's like a crumple on the floor. And if we wanna say that he gets away, then basically the crumple ends with him stopping you two rolling on a bit, and he runs out.
And the scalpel finds your feet.
The scalpel is
sliding across the room.
Yeah.
He'll use his
and at some point, he does get a knee in the
his
groin.
His crack nuts to a D12. That's his complication.
So that comes from he's not running very fast then, is he?
Nope. So you two are in a bit of a tangle. Emhart has gotten away.
Since I have my earpiece in, convict on the loose, red alert.
Oh my gee, now
I'm in the cockpit, right?
Yeah.
I quickly get up and move to lock the door.
Woo, Nova, Zaps, get to the cockpit. Every one of you now lock the goddamn door.
Woo and Nova get to the cockpit. The door's already locked.
And then Isaac will continue with, let them in, Zaps.
No, he's right
let
outside.
Them in.
He's right outside. I know it. He's right
they're
there.
They're both out there. You're safer all together. Let them in.
No. No, he'll get in.
Zaps, let them in. Now.
Woo, the code is 57.
actually,
code is 1111, Woo. Get in there.
No, actually, can...
What?
It's not a keypad system. Can I... can we make an opposed check to see if they can convince?
Yep.
So, you know we're gonna win. So.
Zaps, you'll be setting the stakes.
Okay.
So I'll let you decide how you want to, what you want to affect your dice pool for setting the stakes.
I'm gonna go with mental on this. I don't think social works here correctly.
Yeah, I'm guessing from Woo, it's probably gonna be something like social and trick.
Yeah,
or social
probably.
And influence.
And it's let's say focus. If it can stay focused on this job, and I'll take a little nervous around guns as a. The 8, because this is convincing me that I should really keep the door locked. This is more convincing Zaps of opening
the
door. The
only person out there with the gun is Nova, and you like Nova.
It's 13, by the way. Sorry, yeah. I forgot the extra bit. No, it's like, he's right outside the door, Eliza. He might have a gun. He could be anywhere.
Do Isaac and I get to roll on this or not?
Nope. It's Woo.
Aww.
It's all Woo.
It's all
Woo.
So Woo convinces me to open. It's like, how does Woo convince me to open the door?
Woo's basically like, Zaps, you know how nicely you like to keep your room all orderly and nothing that's out of place?
You wouldn't.
I'm going to trash it. Like you've never known. I'm going to steal all your stuff and put it in everyone else's room, especially my room.
Get in here!
I know you hate it. We just walks calmly through the door.
Close the door behind them.
Yeah.
Or I try to close the door behind them.
Nova offers you a spare pistol.
Okay, I take it.
She also offers you a knife if you'd prefer.
No.
She probably got into my collection.
Oh, she's got her own.
Oh, okay, great! That's even better.
She's a companion. She's,
you have at least
she's
a
not,
gun.
She's not stupid.
There's always a knife under the bed, right? That's how that works?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, or a gun. Or poison. Lots of ways to kill people.
Brass knuckles, actually.
Big Cassie would probably use them.
Ooh, yeah. Zaps will probably say no. Actually, he'll take the gun. I'll take the gun because he thinks he feels safer with it.
Yeah.
He doesn't, but he thinks.
So yeah. So Emhard is loose somewhere in the ship.
And that means Isaac and I are searching him out.
Well, what's Eliza doing first of all?
I did, after Emhart runs, I do turn to Eliza and do a quick medical check. I'm assuming she's physically unharmed at this point.
Physically
everything
unharmed.
Is fine, trademarked Eliza.
Yes.
Also, I'm assuming No Sun Moves is gone?
Yeah.
Yep. That is gone, because that scene's gone.
Yep.
So, yeah. I'm imagining Eliza's a little bit shaken and a little bit embarrassed.
But as long as she's not bleeding.
More so the latter than the former.
Yeah. So as long as she's
especially
not bleeding.
Since when she looked down, it was just a deja vu to the time on the casino thing.
Yeah.
Oh, I
so
thought
it
was
just, oh god, no, not again.
I thought it was a deja vu to the very first scene in this game. She got knocked out.
No. That would have been if I got knocked out while I tried to take him down.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. Okay, so that means I just kind of pat her on the shoulder and then run out. Hopefully trying to meet up with Isaac to do a sweep.
And I'm guessing I find my earpiece and just help out. Not super, like, effectively, but I'll keep my eyes out for him, I guess.
Yep. Are you going to get armed?
Yeah.
Okay, so while you're doing that, and you guys are prepping a search party, Zaps. A small alert goes off in the cockpit.
Oh, great. What is it?
The Mac Knight.
The, nav computer is malfunctioning.
Ah, for the lava.
Was that thing on the Fritz earlier?
Nope. It looks as though it's reporting a fault down in the cargo bay.
Guys, he's doing something in the cargo bay.
Hang on. What's the current status of the McKnight?
You left it behind.
Okay, good.
I grab Boo's hands like, no, Boo, no.
Right. Nia.
No. No.
Where's Eliza?
She's in med, she's fine, and I think she's heading up to her crow's nest to kind of keep a lookout.
Get her to the cockpit.
I'm right here. I suggest we space this fucker now. He's more trouble than he's worth.
Can't kill him, otherwise we don't.
We don't kill him.
Space kills him. There's a difference.
Can I knock her out now?
Eliza, calm down.
No unconscious people on the ship until we find this guy. All right, 3-person teams. Let's go.
Okay.
Three people
in the cockpit, and the three of us go down to the.
We're going to the nav, wherever the nav thing was.
In the cargo bay. Do we have a lot of cargo right now, or is it fairly open?
It's super open.
You've
created space expecting a shipment of ore. And,
yes.
So
good, there's not too many places to hide. Okay. Limited number of hiding spots is good.
Bound to be a few boxes, though.
Yeah.
Captain, can you turn off the lights in the cargo bay?
I'm not a cat.
Sure, why?
Because I think Isaac can see even though it's dark, and I do have a rifle that can see things that is not necessarily lit up.
Okay, but if I knife you two, you know why.
Just stand and watch my ass.
Your ass is not that cute.
Oh, great. It's missing a doodad.
Yeah. What? I can't be bothered to technobabble, so you're missing a doodad.
What?
Fair enough.
We're missing a doodad. For the nav computer.
It? A thingy.
An Ujma flip.
I wish I could adjust that. I have a million and one ideas for what that could be.
Anyway. Okay, so yeah, let's go without lights and I'll try to go off sound.
Yeah, I don't think I can give anybody permission to edit that.
Okay, in that case...
Did I miss something? What am I missing?
It's a line of text at the bottom.
The very bottom of the sheet, in the middle, underneath Zaps, the Daedalus have a complication.
Ah, right.
Daedalus, missing doodad.
Yep.
Okay, I will turn off the lights in the cargo bay then.
We're missing the port nacelle. That's what we're missing.
That's you would have a lot of problems if you were missing the port nacelle.
No, yeah. Because the port nacelle in this universe is something for the nav computer.
Yeah.
I thought it was just missing the superconducting diode.
So, you know where he is at the moment? He was in the cargo bay.
Yes.
Yeah. I turn off the lights. Zaps turns off lights in the cargo bay, maybe only leaving on the emergency lights.
Yeah, so it's that nice, creepy red glow.
Yes.
Yep. So
possibly with some smoke, because, you know, smoke.
The light would be green. Green's better for night vision. Green's better for night vision.
It's red.
It's red because we're cheap.
Yeah.
God damn it.
What, do you think Zaps is going to spring for the good stuff?
I'm an electrician, it would be green! It has
the ship was outfitted before you got here and we're poor. Deal with it.
Don't forget, this is a sci-fi universe. It's creepier if it's red.
Right.
Okay, so the first one is going to be if you can actually see him in the cargo bay, if you've actually caught him.
Okay.
You get to roll a d8 for the darkness.
Okay.
Is this, sorry.
Then what else is it? Is it physical and notice?
Mental and notice,
mental
probably.
And notice.
Mental and notice.
Plus the 12.
So I would get 1, 2, 3, 4 d8 to roll for that.
8 plus d8.
Mental, eight. Notice, darkness. What else do we get on? Oh, yeah, I don't have a specialty on my notice.
I have one with the shadows, so I'm guessing I'm good with shadows and darkness.
Good point.
And d8 mental, d12 notice, d6 threat assessment, d8 glasses, and I'm going to use Guardian Angel as well as a d4.
Can you roll two distinctions?
No, that's my glasses is
your
one.
Glasses is an asset.
Yeah,
that's
okay, I
glasses
have
glasses are a asset.
Signature asset.
D8, darkness, D8 mental, D10 notice, and I think I can include deadly aim or Wudang style in this.
Yeah.
Okay.
1, 2, 3.
I'm ruling Guardian Angels a disadvantage because I've got to try and look after everyone else as well.
Well.
Punch it, Chewie.
If this is 5 ones, I'm gonna flip my shit.
Ooh.
Well, Nia's got a bead on him.
The one who doesn't have night vision has a bead on him.
Listening. He's behind the box.
I see him as well.
Yep.
Alright.
Isaac?
I rolled a 13.
Oh, you see, you did. See, you missed. Yep. But you don't see him.
He's at 2 o'clock behind some boxes, or wherever he is.
Okay, yeah.
You think you see him in the shadows. So I was just checking exactly how this one works. So you think you see him in the shadows. What do you want to do?
I would like to try to sneak behind him and take him, like, just knock him to the ground. Eliza, I'm taking it. You want to do a full frontal assault? Hello?
Nav, you're the boss.
Sorry, wasn't paying attention. So, sorry.
You should stop inhaling all that asbestos. Not
yeah.
good for you.
Probably best. You make it sound like that's a bad thing.
So we see him. Where did you see him?
He's at 2 o'clock behind that stack of boxes. See it?
Yeah.
Almost right under emergency light.
Right, yeah, got it. I'll go left and make a distraction. You guys come up from behind him.
Okay, then Nia starts sneaking off along the wall, trying to go between the shadows, catch up on him from behind.
So we're still going to try and take him out in a fair fight. God damn it.
Get into position to attack him, you realize that he had managed to set something up to create a useful-looking shadow. He's not actually there.
False alarm! He's somewhere else.
Oh, god damn it.
Isaac, you went in the opposite direction to everybody else, yes?
Yeah.
Oh, god.
I would like you to roll physical and fight, please.
Okay, d10, fight plus d12 plus d6 plus d8. Did I get a plot point, by the way?
No, you did not.
Okay, I need a plot point.
Yeah.
He's attacking me, right?
Yeah. So you'll be setting the stakes here.
Okay.
Remember, you have a D12 extra.
Do I?
Crack nuts.
Yep.
Yeah.
Right. Oh, I forgot about that.
I forgot that.
I didn't roll that on seeing him because.
So that's.
So that makes it a 16.
16.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I just remembered. Because I cracked his nuts.
I cracked his nuts.
We cracked his nuts together, okay? It was a team effort.
Uh-huh.
Don't you hate it when somebody takes your nut cracking?
Did you also roll the d8 for it still being dark? Because that's still
that's a benefit
advantage.
To us.
Yeah.
Me? Okay.
Are you...
It's higher than a 10 or a 6. I mean, what? Nope. Nope.
Ooh.
That's only a 12.
So you win. You do get on top with a 16.
Oh. Oh, yeah. That might actually step up the complication by itself.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, Emhard attempts to get the jump on you from behind. What do you do?
So, is he jumping down at me or on?
Yeah.
Right.
As,
so he...
as you run left, he leaps off a couple of cargo containers where you hadn't seen him at all. He was in pitch darkness. Tries to land on your back.
Okay. So he, I will allow him to like latch onto me, and then Isaac will. Keep moving, spin around, and slam him into the nearest wall.
Yeah.
I thought you were gonna do a suplex.
You can't suplex
from
the back.
I would have punched him nuts again while he was in the air.
I was hoping you'd drop to one knee and just throw him over you.
No, that's coming. Sidewalk slam.
That's coming later. If he wasn't jumping onto my back, then I would have thrown him over the shoulder. Mm. But
Wait, he's jumping onto your back. You could have RKO'd him. You could have super RKO'd him! RKO'd him!
That's not how
there.
Isaac fights.
But it's so flashy.
Yeah, so... Yeah, Emhard is taken out.
Oh, in that case, I slam him into the back, and then I grab his neck and flip him over the front.
Yeah. Onto the floor?
And smack him in the face.
At this point... We have seen him and run over, and I've got my zip ties out, and we can't make some handcuffs on him.
Yep.
Zip ties are whatever we're using in this universe. I have a bolo, too.
Zop straps, right?
Yeah.
Zap straps.
No, wait, no. I'm sorry. Zippity whiz bangs.
Zoop stroops.
Yes.
Zippity snaps.
Stroops.
Zippity whiz bangs. I still like zippity whiz bangs.
Okay.
It was fun looking at the two people in the background, both Nav and Laura, and trying to figure out what they're playing.
This looks like a fuck is Borderlands 2. No.
I see, and I'm assuming Dan is playing.
Dungeon Master or whatever the newest Wolf of the World. Yeah, that's the one. That's the one.
Yeah,
you can even see Taz. He's really bit.
Yeah, right. I saw it. Is he kitty?
Yes.
Get in the hole. Aw, okay. Well, was worth a try. Just while you're flipping through
you
that,
have you have access to the cortex up there. I mean,
you can see Wu being like, oh,
what?
Clearly interested, and Saps is like, just staring in the middle distance.
Why do we have Yaoi involved?
Wasn't that a thing?
Wu doesn't think Zaps will be interested in the magazine she's reading.
It's a fashion magazine.
That's what Wu calls it.
The one you're reading. He asked if you had another.
Yeah.
That one didn't necessarily have to be a fashion magazine.
No, it's, like she said, does not have another magazine. At least not one you'd be interested in. I'm assuming it's old fashioned mag.
So yeah. No, boys, better out. Yeah, Emhard is taken out here. This was his high stakes roll, so that would have taken you out if you had failed. And yeah, as you knock him out, from out of a pocket falls the missing doodad. For the computer.
Good. The missing doodad.
Oh, good.
So yes, Eliza! Do the thing
with
doodad, please.
Saps, I have a doodad. How do I retrofit this?
Oh, is it the doodad? basically, just stick it in the whatchamacallit and twist the thingy. You should be fine.
Cool.
Do we have to roll for this?
Roll for this, because good. Because then I'd blow up the ship.
Yeah, the complication just goes away.
Cool.
Like, otherwise I'd have come down, but I'm just assuming it's a very simple part.
My that fix is four. Yeah. I couldn't fix a bag of tea.
I realize I should have had some creepy music in the background for that section. But
oh, yeah. Oh, well.
I'm happy that you didn't, because it's getting dark here.
As you can tell, it's still 1 o'clock in the afternoon here.
So you've got M-Hard
resecured
with Zoop's troops.
Yep. Yes.
And he's currently unconscious again.
I like it like that.
Can we leave it like that?
How about we just put him on the operating table, tie him down, and leave him in the fucking room with no one there?
That worked really well last time.
Because he got out with some of us in there.
Yeah, but when the room is locked and with no one in there, he wouldn't have a hostage to negotiate himself out with.
Okay, question. If he got off the operating table, putting him back there probably isn't going to work, so where are we putting him this time? Unless we, like, chain him down this time or something.
Hang on. Did she specify that he needed to be in mint condition when we handed him in?
No.
Just alive.
He's going to move his fucking hands.
That's not going to work.
Yeah, that's outside the realm of plot here.
Might have a problem with that.
Yeah.
We'd have to explain that to the Alliance facility. Look, let's just... Alright, let's just tie him down and then have someone watch him from outside in the locked room. And we make sure it's actually clear of stuff this time.
Also, other thing, I say we just keep him sedated for the rest of the trip. Screw any risks of that.
He could die. You want to lose your money after all this?
Is sedation different to...
Sedation is different to cold sleep.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah.
Alright, so we can do sedation.
Wait. Didn't they say that he was allergic to sedation?
No,
he's allergic to the
I can't put him
stuff.
In a coma.
So what was he allergic to?
He's allergic to the meds you need to give somebody to put them in suspended animation.
Basically. Oh, okay.
So we can just leave him sedated and woozy and just hook him up and then...
Basically,
at least
sedation
woozy.
Is
That's
going
probably
to
best.
Use up a lot of Eliza's supplies of meds.
I'm not happy about it, but I can do it.
How much farther do we have to go to drop him off?
Yeah, how long?
Let's see, you were 8 hours in, let's say, by the time you tracked him down, put the navcom and stuff back in. We'll call it another day and a half.
Sure. Keep woozy.
So, light sedation.
Yeah, light sedation. Just enough so that he's not entirely able to focus. And then all the other precautions.
You know what? I'll put him under medium sedation. I don't care. We're just going to have to resupply.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Well, you're heading to an Alliance world, so...
And with a bit of luck, we can get a discount on that stuff.
With a bit of luck, they'll reimburse us.
With a bit of luck, they won't arrest us.
We did our job.
Oh, come on. He got out. The only thing we did was take some extra precautions. Knowing the Alliance, they'll laud us for it.
Just make sure we wake him up before we give him in, because, you know...
Yeah.
They don't need to know we're torturing him.
It's not torture to keep him sedated.
I think technically under some convention it is, but whatever.
On the other hand,
don't think so.
Alliance. Mia, to be fair, you'd be surprised how little Alliance would care about that.
Oh, I'm aware, but you know, we try to be better than the Alliance.
Sometimes, I try to be at the outset. At some point, I stop.
Okay. So, obviously, the rest of this is going to move at the speed of plot, but I want to give you guys a chance to unlock yourselves from the bridge and maybe talk to Eliza before we actually get to Constance.
Cool.
Okay, yeah, no. How are you doing, Eliza? You okay?
I'm fine.
Okay.
You she's get not some bleeding. Sleep.
Sounds like she's had some of her own morphine.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Just go get some sleep.
Probably for the best. Are we still putting
probably check her alcohol stores.
Are we still putting it...
I did steal a bottle or two of scotch. Not the cheap one, neither.
Isaac will go down to the, where we've got Emhard and keep an eye on him.
Keep your door locked at night, Eliza. Keep your door locked at night.
Well, wasn't
I'll
it my shift
I'll buy you
next?
A replacement. I'll buy you a better bottle. Share it with her.
Wasn't it Nia's turn for guard anyway, so I should probably go down and watch him. Alright, I'll take the first shift on watching him outside the door.
Give the guy some extra sedation. I'm going back to bed.
Isaac should probably go back to bed too.
Like, sleep for an hour or two more. And then I'll probably go look at our patient.
Or Isaac can sit in the cockpit and watch things.
Yeah, I can do that.
Okay.
He's awake anyways.
I mean, you can fall asleep at the wheel over there. There's proximity alert set up.
I mean, for the record, no one's ever seen, like, Isaac actually asleep.
Except we know you take your clothes off.
Yeah, I do.
We do know that you don't sleep commando, though.
Yep. That would be highly improper.
Well, that's assuming he had a lot of clothes already on. He might have also put on his undies. Just forgot the last bit.
Yeah.
How do you remember your boxers but not your pants?
Easy. You start with your boxers.
Look.
Never mind.
Look, don't even worry about it. It's fine. What? Where? I'm in the cockpit, and I'm keeping an eye on things. I've got a camera set up in the medbay now as well.
And I'm just sitting there biding my time, watching through the door, not looking terribly interested, but enough to know that he's breathing and all that good stuff.
Yeah, presume Eliza's set up some monitors so you can watch his heart rate and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. With alarms in my room, if necessary.
I do have the intercom on, though, so I can hear.
I'm assuming you and Isaac are just making small talk while you're both working.
Well, yeah, and also the comm to inside the room so I can hear in there.
What was the last episode was Revenge is the diff... Yeah, that's the one. Okay. So that's where we are in that.
Was it Revenge is the best...
There's best stuff twice. Yeah. Yeah, so Isaac and Nia are just sort of generally chatting, and Isaac is, like, casually deflecting questions from Nia about certain things that she keeps trying to find out about and just aren't relevant. Not necessary.
Oh, not relevant. And
Isaac is actually telling her about how he doesn't believe that the Westlake is a real thing anyway, because the people that we've heard talk about it have been absolute insane nut jobs.
Oh, I don't disagree. I just, you know.
Oh, Zaps does.
Yeah, and I think it's a waste of our time to go that far out into space for something that may not be real. But, now that we're talking about it, how much cortex access do you have?
We're on the same ship. We've got the same cortex access that we had before. Why does that not let you use the cortex?
Use the Wi-Fi. No, it just seems your glasses are kind of special.
No, the glasses aren't special at all. They're fairly normal. Almost standard issue, we might say. But I have some old friends. I mean, don't forget, I was in the army for a good few years, and I, you know, those sort of bonds hold together.
Ah.
So I know people.
So you favor the Alliance, then?
In terms of what?
Well, you said army.
Yeah, I was in the Alliance army.
Okay. Just checking.
I thought I told everyone that. Oh, no, you weren't here, were you?
Yes!
Interesting. No, I served. I mean, you were here when I was talking to Seth about it, but I don't know if you were paying too much attention.
I don't remember at what point. Maybe it depends on who was getting shot at the time.
She was distracted by those loving glances you two shared.
Yeah, I kind of just let that go. I mean,
Don't bring that up. That's look.
I'm sorry. That's painful.
You're asleep. Fuck off.
What's that about, Seth?
Wakes up from fucking slumber to go, you bet you missed Seth.
I'm happy for anybody to find love.
Well, in this line of work, that doesn't usually end up the way you hope it does.
Yeah.
Actually, you just avoid it if at all possible. It's a hindrance.
Right. Okay.
Isaac, while you're in the bridge, you notice...
Yes, Keith.
You notice that Nia, she's got a little bit of cortex access down there. Something that's fascinating, because Firefly is pre-smartphones, so they never showed anything like pads with internal ship Wi-Fi, but I'm assuming they exist.
Yeah.
And you notice that somebody just did a search for your military record.
Oh, do you think I'd be that obvious about it? Yeah, I probably would.
I expected as much. I mean, you know.
I mean, his surface military record is small, fairly standard. There's not much in there.
It's all on the record. Yeah.
Anything that's small and fairly standard is usually faked.
Check date. Oh, I can't remember the date. I reel off the date of the battle of the Second Battle of Verbena. Point her to the severely wounded in action casualty list. Yep. That's why it was small.
Yeah. His record finishes with medical discharge.
Jack seems to have dropped, by the way.
No, I'm here.
No, wow.
Elijah's just doing the 1,000-yard stare in her cabin with a bottle of scotch.
Laura, you actually come up with
I'm sleeping and eating.
A citation for bravery.
I'm eating in real life and sleeping in game.
A citation for bravery and a medical discharge, like, on the same line.
Well, that must have been an interesting wound you had there.
That was a hell of a day.
Yes.
He got shot in the butt! Running away!
By a brown coat sniper.
Yeah.
Nobody don't worry about it!
Nia would actually probably not dig that deep. She just wants to see if he actually was in the Alliance, if he did serve, and how much he was tied to the Alliance, how strong are his Alliance ties.
Wait, you were shot by a brown coat sniper?
Yeah, I was.
Yes!
Oh.
It was a short little brown coat sniper.
Not in the butt.
The butt.
No, that's a joke, but...
We'll come back to that. We'll find out where I was shot.
Yeah. So that wound...
I mean, as you say, sort of from first glance, it's exactly what you would expect from somebody who served in the Alliance military during that time.
And there's been no link up for the Alliance after the discharge.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what did you do after your discharge? Go back to your home planet?
Huh. It's too cold. No, I got into this gig. I've been mercenary bodyguarding my way across the universe.
Oh, who's your employer?
Who's yours?
I don't have one.
Neither do I.
Can I do you a quick clandestine check on his bank records?
You can.
Go ahead.
You see, he gets a regular wage.
Nobody else on the ship gets a regular wage.
Hey. That's
very important to Japs.
Wait, sorry.
You can wake up. You guys are afraid to walk in. You guys are afraid to walk in on this.
No. I want you kids to have this.
That does flag an alert on your glasses, though, Isaac.
And I intend for it, too, by the way.
Yeah. Yes, some of us do get paid, Nia. Is that a crime now?
Oh, I was just wondering who it came from. You know, fair disclosure and all.
There's disclosure and disclosure. It's look, all that matters is that I need to be here and I need to protect Zaps.
Protect him from what?
What? Have you met the guy?
Okay, that is a fair point, and I will give you that.
Christ. This is a man who can get himself into world-ending trouble putting on his, you know... In fact, having his morning shave.
Probably,
I'm pretty sure he caused an international incident last time he went to the bathroom. So far on my list...
Nira starts laughing so hard she starts choking.
I have a threat board in my quarters, and so far he's managed to piss off people ranging from Badger through to...
Hey, he deserved it.
I can't remember the name of that Alliance lieutenant that we met in the first episode.
Yeah.
You weren't there.
I can't remember either. That was a long time ago.
Anyway, that guy. Riz managed to piss off everyone from the furthest reaches of the criminal underworld to, like, random dude in the Alliance. And everyone in between, including owners of scrapyards, engineers,
yeah, we don't really have
triads.
He pissed off the guy who owns half of Persephone.
Yeah, that guy. The Baron of, what's his face?
Baron
Fairchild. That's why he requires protection.
I guess somebody's interested in probably getting paid at some point.
Surprisingly, the only person you haven't pissed off was Niska.
Yeah. Weirdly. And he double-crossed us, so we're going back to piss him off.
No.
I'm behind this idea, but you make a good point that why didn't he piss off Niska? Niska's actually very easy to piss off.
Fear mostly.
Possibly, but to me, Niska's not. I'm not afraid of him that much. As long as you play by his rules, you should come out okay. Of course, his rules aren't fair, but that's what you get with dealing with a criminal mastermind.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I don't know what you're. Seeing as we're talking so much about me here, how come you're so used to dealing with criminal masterminds?
I told you, I'm a first mate for hire. I go and work for wherever I can find it, if that includes being a Blue Sun mercenary.
So why are you here?
I needed to get away from the small backwater planet I was trapped on.
But why are you still here?
Well, we haven't really gone anywhere yet, and I haven't seen a reason to get off, so
we've been
here.
All the way out to the Black and back. Something's
yeah, that was a little tiring. Let's not do that again. What? It's easier not to be found here. You guys are good at not being found.
Wedding of the millennium.
I'm still waiting for that to catch back up with us, but, you know...
Although, in fairness, that was mostly related to you and yours. That's what caused that. So, the jury's still out.
I told you. I do. This is first mate for hire. I was simply hired on to help with a mercenary crew, and I happen to be good at herding cats. So...
Herding, right?
Herding.
Okay, good. Just checking.
I know Wu is a cat, but...
At this point, Nova comes down, asks if she can just check on the patient's vitals.
Hey, Nova. Yeah. She's
Hello?
I'll let you two... Yeah, Isaac goes back to checking his settings.
I love how that's the description the other characters give of Isaac.
Zaps. Your name is Zaps, dear.
How do I keep doing that?
Because you really, really want to be me.
Apparently.
At this point, you should change names, because then Red will fuck it up even more. Because then he'll start calling himself Saps.
So the rest of the journey passes uneventfully.
Okay.
You arrive at... Maybe the planet's gone from my brain.
Constance.
There we go. It begins with a C, but what is it? I don't remember. Yeah, so you arrive at Constance and you hail the facility.
Ultra Max Q7A.
Yep.
Hail.
Screening for that.
Yep. Communications officer directs you down to the prison spaceport, accepts your documentation, and gives you a landing plan.
Okay. I set in a landing sequence. Oh, actually, is there a chance for me to talk to our little patient?
If you wish, yes.
Because I kind of want to probe his brain for something.
Yep.
So before we do that, I go up to... I don't know who's standing guard at this point. I go up to the...
I'm guessing whoever it is, it'll be Isaac if you're going to go there.
Yeah, probably.
Sorry, what?
Yeah. So Nia has gotten some sleep finally, and it's you and Isaac having personal time.
What am I doing?
You're guarding Kirk.
So we're in my quarters, and no.
Oh, really?
No. No, I'm heading over to the med bay. I'm heading over to the med bay to basically have a little chat with Emhart.
Go ahead. I'm going to be in the room, though.
Sure. So, Mr. Get Out of Your Cage and Wreck Havoc on this ship. There's something you keep talking about, how you need to save people.
Mm-hmm. He says, what haven't seen what's coming. You don't know what like.
What happened on the West Lake?
That doesn't matter.
I think it does. I think it matters a lot, doesn't it? I think that's where all this started.
He just keeps repeating, you haven't seen what's coming. I have to save them.
Should Nia walk in and be and do the re-requesting on him again? I actually got as much information as I needed off of him when we picked him up, but...
I basically want to get him to talk about the location of the West Lake.
Yeah, he's not going to give that to you, I'm afraid.
Okay, well, fine.
And is he going to give us any more information like he was actually captured by the Reavers for a while? I'd be highly surprised if he escaped.
If he was...
I'm assuming I'm just going to keep trying to talk to him for like 15 to 20 minutes captured. And then Zaps at some point just gives up.
Also, you do know what happens to survivors of Reavers.
I do.
Reavers.
Yeah, I don't know if he was... Yeah, that would make no sense for him to have been left out
of... No, because he wouldn't look like he looks.
Yeah.
And he wouldn't be talking either.
Yep.
Wait.
And Reavers aren't smart enough to do something like let a decoy or something out.
Mm-mm.
So, when you land, your ship is met by 3 Alliance guards.
Okay.
Yep.
I escort them to the med bay. I greet them. Say hello.
Yep.
You must be here for the prisoner.
They mm-hmm. ask to see your transfer documents.
Yes, and I'd like to see their identification.
They show you.
Okay, I show them the transfer documents.
Okay, they ask you to bring the prisoner, and they would like you to meet the warden.
Okay, can you guys help picking him up? He's been a bit of a trouble, and I'd like the extra guards.
They say that if you guys can pick him up, they will provide covering fire with their weapons, as you won't be permitted weapons inside.
You've got 2 people who can pick him up.
Okay.
We're not allowed weapons inside?
No weapons.
Fair.
They only get weapons. We just pick him up and carry him. They can shoot him if they want to.
It's the same system with... We don't have any weapons on our ships either.
I'm really bored of on-site procurement.
Then why are you a mercenary bodyguard? Because we are having this conversation.
I get to keep my weapons normally. Come on, you're coming with us.
And I was like, I actually like on-site procurement. It's a little challenging. We walk him along.
I'm assuming Wu is also coming.
Apparently.
Yeah, please do.
It's called being a professional.
Eliza, are you down there with them?
Meeting the warden is going to be way more fun with Wu there.
Mm-hmm.
I think Jack's still not there.
I'm eaten.
Oh, then I'm just not hearing him anymore.
Okay, so
I'm actually going to refresh. Hope that helps.
Eliza, what we need you to do is roll your mental and notice with your specialty in anatomy, please.
Okay. Do I also get the doctor part?
Yep.
You need so I haven't heard Jack for like the last 15 minutes.
Mostly because I've been eating.
Yep.
Yeah. Not the only reason.
So mental notice, my anatomy specialty.
Yep.
And the doctor part.
Mm-hmm.
So 1, 2, 3, and that. Okay. Is there anything else that I get? Probably not.
Nope.
Cool.
Bang! Nice.
Impressive. One of the guards, she looks a bit nervous. Keeps fingering the trigger of her gun.
I just tell her, don't worry about it. He's crazy, but it's not all that bad.
Yeah, he's really crazy.
Okay, now Nav has fallen away from me. I'm assuming he's still there for you guys, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
It's so weird. Why does it keep saying the stream wasn't able to connect due to a network error?
Don't know.
Okay, let's try that again.
Can you still hear me? Oh, okay, right. Well,
he's just refreshing to try it again.
Close up some
right.
programs in the hope that helps.
That, wait, hang on, how many guards are there?
3.
Who's holding Emhard?
You and
hey.
I.
Right.
At least I'm there.
Yeah.
She's there, probably, you know, possibly just carrying his personal belongings. I don't know if he had any.
Eliza, help me carry this guy. Nia, you go and stand next to the fancy guard.
Okay. Sure. Hey, Eliza, come pick up his feet. It's a little heavy for me.
Sure.
I start making small talk with the guards. Oh, so how's it going? Get many of these prisoners transferred here often?
It is a high security facility, but never a serial killer of this repute.
Really? Huh. I thought he just did this on a small town. Didn't know he had such a reputation. He killed before?
There's some records in the files that were sent by the sheriff.
Okay.
Was that also in ours? Did we just not read them?
We probably did not read them.
The sheriff basically submitted like a ton of evidence for all of his different crimes.
I probably didn't read everything. I probably read the cliff notes. If there were any.
I probably looked through his medicals and that was about it because...
I got
fascinated by the crazy.
And I just looked at the stack and went, okay, so he's bad news, and went on. So, I guess he's a pretty intimidating individual to talking to the guard.
Yeah. And she nods and keeps moving forward.
That's fine. And he's sedated anyway.
You're taken down this fairly narrow hallway and to a largish elevator. Large enough that you could fit 4 gurneys side by side, so it comfortably fits the crew, Emhard and 3 guards.
Cool.
The nervous guard, she's the one putting in the controls for the lift.
Okay.
I'm probably going to stand right behind her.
Yeah, that's going to help with their nervousness.
I don't know, Nia's not intimidating if she doesn't want to be.
That's fair.
The lift doors close. It starts to rise. And then stops.
I need you to know... What can I roll a notice on this? Because I need to see how she's doing.
Looks like she input some sort of code to override the lift.
Okay, and this is where, if I notice that, I'm going to...
Knock her the fuck out.
Well, at least... lean over and say, are you sure you want to do that?
Knock her the fuck out!
And can you also...
Okay, that's going to be your social and your influence.
Got it. Social. 10. And... I think Wudang style actually applies to that because I am doing this unarmed. Alright.
Yeah, because we're all unarmed.
Yeah. Yep. Alright. Oh! Do we want me to split health healers or to the end? Should I spend a plot point to override that? Or do you want to just have a nice fight and break out?
Up to you. If you don't stop her here, she will knock out the two other guards, and then you guys will have to deal with her unarmed.
She's trying to kill... It's very obvious she's trying to kill Emhart, because I think he murdered someone close to her.
Probably. Anyway, we're doing this in a stress situation, so this is probably not the time to talk about final details.
This is just what Nia would do now.
Yeah.
I mean, Nia would always wants to win every fight she goes into, no matter what. Mm-hmm. So I would spend the plot point, but that means I'll be out and I won't have any for if there's a larger fight later. Just asking the crew if you want me to go down that far.
You still have your callback.
No, I have spent all of my episodes. Oh, wait, not the last one. You're right, I do have a callback for the last episode.
Yeah, you should have a callback to Revenge is a Dish Best or twice.
Wait, actually, you're intimidating them right now, right?
Mm-hmm.
You can't actually spend a plot point anymore to take that 6.
Oh.
Because that's only that's the drawback of defending. You could, because the attacker gets to see what they're finding.
Okay, then. No, I can't
take
it. Could
she spend her plot point to roll her big damn hero die?
I don't know. I'd have to look that up.
Because this feels sort of like the end of this arc. Maybe, possibly.
Well, even though we're in a confined space, I think between the three of us on her...
No, the two of you. I can't fight for shit in close combat quarters. We've seen that demonstrated before.
Oh, I can take
that. Depths can actually be stupidly helpful sometimes. So I think between Isaac, Nia, and Zaps, we can take him out. The question is whether she kills Emhart before we get him up, and how much do we care if she kills Emhart?
Is she trying to kill him?
Possibly. We don't know.
We don't know.
She stopped the elevator. That's about what we know so far. Keep has told us that she'll take out the two guards, but we cannot base our decisions on that fact.
And the thing is, if she's trying to break him, this is not a good place for her to do that. They'll get out of the elevator, and then they've got all the other guards in the fortress meeting them.
Mm-hmm.
So I think she's not going to spring him. I think she's just going to shoot him. Because if you with a record that big, it's more likely he murdered someone near to her.
That doesn't make sense. If she's a guard at the prison, she's got the opportunity to do that any time and make it look like a prison fight.
That's what she doesn't want, is a prison fight. Get him before he gets in the prison. Yeah.
She could also just be stupid.
That would play into either argument. If she's stupid.
Yes.
So, we have to... I think our best option is just take her down.
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. If I lose, I'm gonna try to take her down.
Alright, let's do it.
Alright. So yeah, I lose. She, goes into whatever she's gonna do.
Yep. So she... knocks the... sort of very swiftly knocks the other two guards out with the butt of her weapon and turns and points her weapon at you.
Okay.
Because you're the closest and you tried to intimidate her. She says, you better do what she says or folk will get hurt. Laura, you get a D6 gun to your head complication.
That's not a complication, but sure.
Yes.
Not for you, no. Once she's done that, she says to Emhard, are you ready to stop faking and get out of here?
Faking.
He wasn't crazy after all.
Oh, he's not crazy.
I was.
So, Emhard that you were holding up because he was still supposedly groggy, stands up straight on his own two feet.
I figured. So, what are the other two guards doing?
I'm killing Nova.
How?
Just calling it now. I'm murdering Nova.
Why are you murdering Nova?
Not now, when we get back to the ship.
Why?
Who the fuck else could have made sure that he isn't groggy anymore?
Well, we gotta walk him in. That would kind of be assumed.
Yeah, but if he's still on the medicine on the
maybe
ship, we take him to the...
It.
Yeah, I
no,
don't think
Nova's
got anything to do with this.
Nova's been
Nova's
loyal to us from
are.
The beginning.
Okay, if I can see she acts shocked, then I'm not gonna try and fucking murder her.
Okay,
but
good.
Okay.
Good.
So,
why is Eliza's first response always to murder someone?
Because she doesn't trust nobody, dude.
Sorry.
Anybody.
Dude.
Anyway.
She don't trust nobody.
That is not correct grammar, and I will correct you. okay.
I will say she doesn't trust nobody forever.
And... Well, she points the gun at me and says, I better do what she says, and she's going to break him up. My first thing is to kick the gun out of her hand.
Nice.
Kick.
Nice.
Kick.
Nia's flexible.
Yes. That is my first intention. Or kick her upside the head, whichever one I hit.
Roundhouse kick. Bam!
Okay, that'll be your physical and fight, then.
Okay.
15.
And Wudang style and...
Ah. Physical...
I mean, Emhard at this point is still handcuffed and stuff. He's just standing on his own.
Oh, I do have a specialty in unarmed fighting. Wudang style, definitely. And that is a bonus here. And I do have 1-2 punch, which I will invoke to take out a minor... When I take out... Step up a complication when I take out a minor Game Master character to take out another minor, even though there's not another minor in here.
Okay.
And I don't think I get to call tools of the trade, so... Man, I'm not doing too well today.
Well, you can spend a plot point in this case.
Yeah, I think I will spend a plot point to keep that 4.
Yeah. So, that gives you a success.
17.
The stakes.
17.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Yeah, that succeeds. You knock the guard unconscious.
Okay, great.
You're probably going to have some explaining to do to the Alliance as to why they've got 3 unconscious guards in their left.
I'm
guessing
they
have cameras?
Cameras, yeah.
It's a supermax prison.
And I also have 3 witnesses that will testify she was trying to spring Emhart.
No, wait, it was Ultramax. It's even Ultra.
Hmm. Yeah, Ultramax.
Ultramax.
So,
even
and
more max than super.
Unfortunately, all the lift controls require an Alliance officer to use them.
We look up at the cameras and go, can you get us out of here, please?
Yeah.
And if, don't we have to take care of one prisoner that's still there?
No, hang on.
He's still
out
cuffed.
Out of a pocket, Eliza pulls out her med kit, grabs a shot of adrenaline, punches it into one of the guards... So he just snaps up.
Whoa!
And starts running around the elevator like maniac?
No, it's not like... It's not a high dosage, it's just enough to get him awake.
A super duper max.
They went plaid.
I'd actually like to stand in for... Should I do this? Yeah, I should probably do this. Despite being at a disadvantage in... Saps being slightly afraid. Saps actually wants to go stand right opposite of Emhart.
Yep.
I'm assuming he's taller than me.
Yes.
Isaac, that's yours.
So I'm standing there, like, looking up at him, distance between our noses, like, probably a little bit too small. What's really going on here? Otherwise I'd blast your skull out of you, blast your brain out of your skull right now.
He can do
and
that.
At this point, Nia's probably kicked the gun over to him. He doesn't even know Zaps can't shoot.
As I do this, I just
Saps has one confirmed kill.
Look back in his eyes. I'm basically going for an influence check here.
Well, he's not going to give you anything. And as you're trying to stare him down, the lift starts moving again. And you're shortly deposited at the top of the building at Warden Chun Mi Fang's office.
You got lucky.
As you drag Emhart into the room, he starts immediately protesting to the warden that he was framed, his confession was beaten out of him. He shows some of the injuries he sustained and said, look, they've been abusing me this whole journey, just beating me up.
At which point I put my hand on his shoulder and go, Anjing Yidan, you Chu Wo, and wait. Where's the other one I was looking for? Supposed to be Wu Ming Chao Du, which means shut up, you small, low time horse thief.
Calm down, Nia. It's all right. I'm sure the sheriff can. We can call her, and they she can vouch for us, right? We can send her a wave.
The warden says that the sheriff notified her ahead of time. She's been expecting.
Of course she did.
She says she doesn't believe a word this lying sack of shit is saying, and motions to some really heavily armed guards to take him down to a nice cell.
I walk up to the warden, and I gestured for the warden to just for a moment face to face. How much do you trust those guards?
She says, enough.
Okay.
Are you going to tell her what happened to the elevator?
Sorry, this whole thing has made me a bit paranoid. I hope you understand. I mean, I'm assuming she saw because we got deposited with the person two persons lying unconscious in the elevator.
Yeah. She says you'll notify the sheriff that your end of the bargain is complete and you can get paid.
Good. Oh, and one tip for next time. If you set up a listing for a job, please put the actual job in.
She says she'll take that under advisement. Luna sends you a wave later on to let you know that the money's been sent. She also sends you a package of files.
Okay. What's in the package? I'm assuming I picked this up at some sort of post station a week down the line.
Yep. Inside is a body scan of a prisoner. Specifically of Emhard.
Okay.
And the body scan, the timestamp suggests it was taken 2 years ago.
Okay.
What prisoner where?
I start checking the file. I start reading through it. What? Anything out of the ordinary?
It's from the Westlake.
So it's a body scan while it was still on the Westlake.
As
the Westlake
a prisoner.
Disappeared 6 years ago.
Sorry?
The Westlake
disappeared 6 years ago.
And this scan is from 2 years ago.
Wait, was it as while he was a prisoner on the Westlake, or while just general body scan from the system? Wait, why was he on the Westlake?
If the Westlake has disappeared 6 years ago, this is from 2 years ago, and I guess the Westlake wasn't as missing as we thought.
Ding.
Huh.
Very funny. I can't manage to do whispers. That would make my job too easy.
I mean, it's not that hard, right? It's just slash W and...
Wait a second, 6 is bigger than 2!
Wait, see, it's a good thing I don't normally watch the stream, or I'd be being ruined on all the whispers. I've been missing out on them. I actually have the stream up for once today.
Oh, great, yeah, no, everyone read the whispers. That's fine, yeah, no, everyone should do that right away. Everyone go and read all the whispers.
I'm not reading whispers at all. Don't worry. So I'm assuming there's a whisper going on with someone who we don't know who it is. At all.
I'm just complaining at Keeb, don't worry about it.
Yeah. There's more plot going on. And so that concludes this particular story.
Interesting.
So.
Was there anything else in the files, aside from the fact that it was 2 years ago where that's impossible?
That was the thing of interest. The rest, just sort of things relating to the case about Emhard.
Okay.
Mostly just his evidence.
Interesting that she chose to send that to us as well.
She said she thought you'd be interested.
Yeah, she's not wrong.
Who is this person?
The sheriff.
Sheriff Luna.
And she works for...
The planet Theros.
Presumably
planet.
The Alliance.
Right, so she's like a local law enforcer. Okay, yeah. Got it.
But that doesn't mean she's very tight with the Alliance.
Yeah, that's a loose Alliance.
This one again, a little bit short.
I'm okay with that, actually.
If you failed that roll in the lift, that guard would have escaped with Emhart and then released all the prisoners.
That was worth spending a plot point for, guys.
Absolutely.
Like,
you chose to do it on the first one, and then I was like, is she going to leave this one, or is she going to let it go? And then, yeah. So it was definitely the right choice.
That would have been
the wrong choice.
Yeah, that would have been a lot of fun.
Explosions!
Exactly, that.
I would finally have gotten to use explosives!
Okay, and so the next time we free up all the serial killers in an ultra max prison, which is only superseded by super duper max, you can blow shit up, okay, Eliza?
Yep.
See? Yes! I could finally blow things up!
So, what are you going to call this episode?
Ooh.
I need a stiff drink.
No, that's not the name.
I like something with on ice. Or on the rocks, or I don't know.
Handle with care.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yes, I like
handle
that
with
one.
Care. Well, what did we do? We picked up a serial killer. We fooled some locals. We could call it
hackers as a reference to serial killer. That's a far out link.
No. Looking for a McNugget of wisdom.
just too low.
I actually like handle with care. I think it applies not only us, but he's extremely delicate prisoner.
I hate using the stock answers, but it's probably best.
What was it called?
The actual one is prisoner 3102Y.
Oh, I thought who came up with handle with care?
That was just off the top of my head.
Nice.
He was a package that you were delivering.
I like. Okay, then. I thought Handle with Care was the the
stuff. No.
Okay, then I'm okay.
I mean, you could also go with Crazy on the Rocks, but
Stay Frosty.
I don't know.
I prefer Handle with Care.
Yeah, Handle with Care is fun.
Yeah, not all of us stayed frosty during this. You got to see me lose your temper.
I like how Handle with Care has double meaning in this.
Most of our things have done that.
Yeah. That's the best.
That's why we use the naming scheme we do.
Yep.
And so, what I will leave with you with for next time is having picked up this package and seen these files. I presume you're still in system. You've maybe not left Constance, or you went back to Murag, whatever.
Could I start talking shop with the warden to get refilled with my medicine?
Yeah.
Reimbursed. And we got paid for this job, right?
Yeah, but I would try to seek reimbursement for the medicine that I needed to use on him, but I'm guessing that the Alliance is cheapskates and don't want to do that.
She realizes when you tell her some of the story just how much you had to sedate him, so she'll reimburse you for the medicine.
Awesome.
Nice.
Free stuff.
Yeah.
Free stuff we already used, so it's only replenishing.
Good enough.
Still free.
So, assuming you're still in system, you've picked up the package. That was about a week after dropping M-Hard off.
Yeah.
A week today is Unification Day.
So it's today or in a week?
In a week.
Okay.
It's U Day a week from now.
Are we going to end up wearing brown coats in an Alliance bar?
No.
That's for you guys to decide. So,
no.
We happen to be in system, which is... I need to remember the system name.
Bank holiday.
U-Day is a bank holiday, yes.
Yeah. We're in Kaladasa, which, as we know, contains both Constance and Verbena.
Verbena, yep.
So, your challenge, for as we start the next episode, is to decide where you'll be spending U-Day.
Constance or Verbena?
Well, I mean, we're in the Kaladasa system.
You can go
anywhere
in the system. That's why I've given you a week. Basically,
I have a feeling Verbena is significant to certain individuals in the crew.
Yes. Wait, isn't...
I think Kaladasa... we need to go visit a bar on Verbena.
Hang on, isn't Kaladasa... no, we're not. Isn't Kaladasa at the location of one of the episodes?
Yes, so. That's exactly what I'm going for.
I can't remember if they went to Kaladasa. I can't remember.
We could absolutely do a flashback. It would just be super confusing to everyone.
Yeah. It won't be a flashback, but there will be some opportunities for story development.
Constance happened.
For a flashback episode. Basically, we're all playing. So we're all playing characters in Isaac's past in that episode. Now they're our characters.
Because. Oh, I don't know if I can say that. About me.
Most of you are playing characters.
Constance was in.
I think we should do this, Keeb.
Comic
Isaac flashback episode.
If we can figure out how to do one, then yes, we will.
We're kind of on what feels like an arc at the moment. But if you want to drop out of that, just do something else, I'm fine with that.
Yeah, we've got a nice little arc going with the West Lake.
Oh, it was Beaumont. Beaumont is where the episode happened.
Yeah, Beaumont, that's right.
It is, because...
But because we're in system, like original. I thought it seemed a really nice idea to... We've been meaning to pick up on the Verbena connection. There's two of you guys to Verbena.
I say we take
a breather in this West Lakes arc.
Yeah.
Just a breather episode?
That's usually fine. If you have an arc, it's sometimes interesting to do an episode that's not related to the arc and then come back to it again.
Well, what are you guys hoping to find out? Because there's some stuff I might have to write.
Who you're working for? Why?
Why would that come up in a flashback episode?
This would be your start in whichever bar you choose on U-Day.
Okay.
And there is a story. The original version was written that it takes the crew to... It doesn't necessarily start on U-Day, but I thought it was quite a nice way to tie it into this. The original story ends up with them doing some searching around in a bunker at Serenity Valley.
Oh, okay.
So I'm going to rewrite this to take place on Verbena, because all of the stuff that one brought up about Serenity Valley works really well for bringing up stuff about Verbena, because we have... two combatants, one from either side. Cool. I also thought it'd be quite fun to see how you guys all react on U-Day.
Yeah.
Thank you. I will have to come up with something.
Pulling on my brown coat, finding an alliance bar, looking for a fight.
Nia is just going to be following people around, keeping them from dying on U-Day.
Yeah. I also thought it followed really well with Eliza as well.
Yeah.
We've just thrown Reavers at her.
Mm-hmm.
So
now
where
we're
going
to throw her onto Verbena, potentially.
So we want to go to Verbena then and have you stay there?
You will start somewhere in system.
Where do you guys think you'll start? Where do all that... leaving Isaac out of it and the fact that we know things about that, where does everyone else want to spend U-Day?
I think Beaumont would actually make sense.
Or as Wu calls it, Wu-Day.
Yeah.
Wu wants to be in a bar, I'm assuming.
Yes.
Wu doesn't care which bar, but I would say Beaumont actually makes sense because we can have... It's the capital of the system, so we would go there looking for jobs, looking to get restocked on everything.
Felk, what do you...
Maybe do some actual trading.
Felk, what were you trying to say?
I was going to say, Wu's just probably going around trying to find as many free drinks as you can.
Just being very celebratory, grabbing somebody, giving it around, then going to the next bar, doing the same thing over. Yeah.
So if anybody's interested, I've just popped a link into both chats for the list of planets in the Kaladasa system.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But yeah, that's why I've given you a week, so you've got enough travel time to get anywhere.
Yeah, there's so...
Most of these systems are huge. And each planet has lots of moons, and so there's lots of inhabited places.
There's like 4 planets destroyed?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Where's Verbena?
Verbena's number 2.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You were on number 3, I think. Khalid, whatever it was.
Constance.
Well, you went to Constance. I was right, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
You started on Kuan Lo, and you went to Constance.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
I have no idea what any of these planets are, so...
Most of them are very minor.
Usually appeared somewhere in the canons, so.
Yeah, and the rest of them are generally also smaller. I think, Janali's not small, but. Hmm. Yeah. I will say I have no links in this system, so it doesn't matter to me where you guys choose.
Yeah. But yeah, this is going to kind of be the Isaac Eliza episode.
Mm-hmm.
Like it.
This one, like because it's a longer format one inserted into the middle of these series of short ones, so this will probably take 3 or 4 sessions rather than the 2 that we've been squeezing these into.
That's fine.
We'll get them into.
Yeah.
We'll find an important NPC to kill to speed this up.
I mean, you're not wrong.
I was quite pleased with how that worked out, because I was like, oh shit, he was supposed to release... M-Hard, how am I going to make this work? And
you have Eliza.
Thank you, Jack, for playing into that.
Well, I mean, the thing is, it also fits with Eliza's character. So
nice.
Yep. Yeah, I'd like to learn about Eliza too. Like, you know, obviously, Reavers scare everyone, but why is she so especially haunted by them?
Maybe you should ask
her.
Maybe
probably not going to learn about
rather than
that
interrogating, rather than interrogating me every goddamn session.
But you're so terribly suspicious, Isaac, and Eliza isn't. She's
very simple. She wants to kill everybody.
Are you trying to tell me that having unclear motivations and an uncertain employer is suspicious, Laura? Are you trying to tell me that?
Everyone knows who I work for here.
Yeah. Yeah, no,
I don't get paid.
I think they do.
Well, I presume Zach's just paying you a share of each mission.
Yeah.
I'm assuming. Yeah, I'm assuming. And, I have a place to call home, and I am not currently on the run.
What better way to infiltrate a group that Lu Sun are interested in them by saving them and then helping them out?
Well, it is a rather useful tactic, yes.
Yeah. Isn't it?
But yes, you guys also get to add to your list of allies. The Warden.
We have an ally! Finally!
Wait, no, now we have many.
Question.
We have a bunch now.
Question. Who's keeping this list?
Of our allies? Yeah. Not me.
I'll keep it, because I'm the one that mostly removes people from it, so...
Yeah.
Because I just realized I haven't been keeping score of that, so it might be good to have a list.
Well, your list of allies currently, I think, is Liliana Fairchild and Daniel.
Yes.
Because you did have Eli, but he's gone out for one last trek into the black.
Right.
And he helps us out first.
Oh, you do have the crew of the Malmadra.
Oh, yeah.
You spare them.
Shoot them.
They owe you.
Yep.
Hey, I never plan on killing them. I was just like, well, maybe we should have them solve their own shit.
Sheriff.
Look, I'm all for killing people when it's necessary, but that was not necessary.
No, I agree.
Shouldn't me fang on Constance.
I just wanted to hobble them a little bit. Be like, here's enough pieces to put it all back together. Good luck. We're out.
That's fine, as long as you're nice about it.
Yeah.
Where was it, Kyle was? It was on some sort of moon.
Oh, right. We also have
It was the moon of Persephone, wasn't it?
Yeah, was it Regina?
Yeah, I think it was Regina.
No, Regina's...
Okay. Yeah. It's on a moon of Persephone. We'd have to figure out which one. We have that wiki page you just gave us.
Part of the universe, right?
Yeah.
Kalidasa.
And Liliana and Daniel were on...
They're somewhere out on the rim.
Yeah.
Rim question mark.
White Sun System.
And Alamadra is on question mark.
Mm-hmm. Persephone's moons are Hades and Renau. You were on Renau.
Renau.
Yep. R-E-N-A-O.
I knew it began with an R.
Yes.
Now, so we have Liliana and Daniel, the Malamadra, Sheriff Cao, Warden Chunmi Fang, and Sheriff Mariluna.
Yep.
Are those our actual list of allies?
Yes.
Yep.
Yeah.
You've been doing.
We're doing okay now.
Not too bad. More recently, you've done quite well.
I wonder
like
why.
The first couple where you just alienated everybody and double crossed and triple crossed them.
Hey, I got paid. That's all that matters.
You nearly got spaced.
Twice.
No, I've only gotten nearly spaced once. Like, really, actually.
You have no idea how much Nia's wanted to space you a couple times.
Yeah,
and I don't think the crew would have
missed the very first episode.
Yeah, Laura.
Isaac actually put her in the airlock and had a hand over
the controls. They did the same as they did with Jane.
She tried to betray us to the Alliance.
I didn't try to betray you to the Alliance. I just wanted to get paid for the fugitive.
You didn't try to betray us to the Alliance. You did betray us to the Alliance.
Accidentally! It was an accident. I wanted to get more money.
Bearing in mind,
accidentally betray someone.
Bearing in mind, the person Eliza was betraying was another brown coat who she should have been in favor of because they should have been war buddies. But she has no loyalty to her former friends.
No,
at all.
I know, I believe you. This is why if she gets herself taken out, Nia is not doing medical aid to her.
Fair.
But yeah, so that's the board reset ready for next time.
All right.
Sweet.
And so that will hopefully be 2 weeks' time, which will be the...
Does that work for me? Yes,
something
it does.
The 10th.
The 10th. Which is conveniently the weekend before pre-release weekend, so...
Yes, I will
And
not.
It's after July 4th!
Oh, that's the Sunday, so it's Sunday 10th of July.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we'll stick with Sundays for now.
Cool.
I think we're
at
still
8
on
o'clock?
The alternate Sunday... Yeah. I think we're still on the alternate Sunday to Culture Clash, so that should be...
No, we're not.
No, we're not.
We're on the Culture Clash Sunday right now.
Oh, well.
Which is fine.
Yeah.
Okay. Guys, like what we talked about pre, I'll keep you updated on how things are changing.
Cool. Yep.
Also, a heads up, I won't be available the 17th and the 24th because I'll be on holiday.
That's fine. we will sort some times out after that. But yeah, thank you everybody for watching, and this episode will go up on YouTube sometime in the week, and the missing episode will be up when Red gets time, but no rush on that, Red.
I'm hoping to do that this week, but no promises.
It happens when it happens.
Exactly.
Cool. Thanks, guys.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.